Hello everyone, I am Shivantika, legal intern at Lexis & Company for the month of June, and today in this video we will understand the differences between indemnity and guarantee. We all know that these both are contracts, and let's talk about indemnity first. So indemnity is when one party promises to compensate the loss occurred to the other party due to an act of the promisor or any other party itself. Okay. On the other hand, guarantee is when a person assures the other person that he or she will perform the promise or fulfill the obligation of the third party in case he or she makes a default. Okay, so we'll come to the differences. We have already discussed the meaning. A contract in which one party promises to another that he will compensate on behalf or for any loss suffered by him is a contract of promise to the third party, is an indemnity. Therefore, it is a kind of reimbursement that you are giving to the other party, that in case this or this happens, that is in case of some contingency, you will compensate such person. For an example, the general insurance. What happens in such a situation? You are assuring the other party that in case, for example, in motor vehicle assurance, okay, insurance, what happens in that case? You are insuring the other party that in case any damage is caused to your vehicle, I will insure that vehicle, I will pay for the compensation in that case. And in return, what do you pay? You pay some premium amount, a minimum premium amount for that matter. But in case of guarantee, it is not so. It is a contract in which a party promises to the other party that he will perform the contract or compensate the contract or compensate the loss in case of any default by the third party. This is mentioned under section 126 of the Indian Contract Act, whereas the indemnity is mentioned in section 124 of the Indian Contract Act. In a contract of guarantee, there are basically three parties. Suppose there is X, Y, and Z. X makes a contract with Y. X asks Y that he wants some good from Y, but he cannot pay right now. So what X does is he takes some goods from Y, but Y says that there should be a person giving surety on your behalf that you will make the payment on time. Alright, so here Z becomes the surety on behalf of X and tells Y to give him the goods or to give him the loan. And what he will do, if X does not pay, then Z will pay on X's behalf. What is this? Here, Z is becoming the surety, and he is assuring Y that if X fails, then he will step into the shoes of X and pay on his behalf. Alright, so there are three parties. What we can name them? X, Y, and Z. X is the principal debtor here. Alright, Y is the creditor, and Z is the surety. He is the surety. What we call it is the surety. But in fact, in contract of indemnity, there are only two parties. For example, in insurance, you have a contract with your insurance company. So there is only two parties. One, that is you and the insurance company. You are the indemnity holder, and you are the indemnity holder in this case. And the insurance company is the indemnifier in this case. So therefore, number of contracts, there is a difference of number of contract between two parties. Here only one contract will happen in case of indemnity. Whereas when we talk about a contract of guarantee, there are three people as well as there are three contracts involved. How three contracts? One contract between X and Y for the contract for taking the loan. All right. Another is between Y and Z that he will pay on behalf of X. And another catch is here, there is also a contract between Z and X, as if in case he makes a default and he does not pay, and Z has to pay on behalf of X, then Z has all the authority to claim that amount from X, as he had stepped into his shoes and paid on his behalf. Now he can want that money back, or he can claim that money back from X. So there are three contracts involving or revolving between the parties itself. Three parties, three contracts. There are two parties, but there is only one contract in indemnity. In guarantee, there are three contracts. Now let's talk about the degree of liability. Here in indemnity, the liability of the indemnity holder is primary, all right? But in case of guarantee, the primary liability is of X, that is the principal debtor. The principal debtor has the first responsibility to pay off the debt that he has taken from Y. If he fails to do so, then surety will come in play, and he has the secondary liability in such a situation. So basically, what is the purpose behind all of this? So the purpose of indemnity is to compensate the losses, whereas the purpose of guarantee is to give assurance to the promisee that the payment will be done.